There are very few new features in Final Cut 10.5, considering it's a full 1-point upgrade. Superficially, it just looks like an upgrade to suit the Apple Silicon Macs. And not mentioned in the flash screen about the new features is the return of chapter markers now working correctly in the new version. However, there's one new feature that really will help people who are collaborating over the internet, and that's the easy ability now to create a proxy-only library without having to worry whether proxies are already created or not. No decision to make, just make a new proxy-only library. And it's not only for internet transfers that these smaller proxy sizes are useful. If you're doing on-the-road editing with a laptop, or even with an older processor and a laptop, these smaller proxy sizes are very useful for you. There is, however, a secret that I should show you how to create an even smaller proxy library, because the default proxy library will use ProRes proxies rather than the smaller H.264 proxies. So unless you've set this up in your own preferences, you will get the ProRes larger size proxy file. I'll show you how to make those smaller H.264 proxies. And this example of a small project will show you how much bigger a ProRes proxy library is compared to an H.264 proxy library, which is about a quarter of the size. And one more thing is the return of the ability to download the user manual as a PDF for Final Cut, and also now as an iBook. The link is in the description below. I'm Bruce McBride, and I can provide one-on-one tuition over the internet for Final Cut. Just click again in the link below. First, I'll show you how to check if your clips have optimized or proxy media already created. So if you select a clip and go up to the white eye, you can see down here at the bottom of the inspector, both proxy and optimized are red and originals green. So there's only original media in this clip. So now to create the proxy only library, select the project in your event. Moving up here, you can see copy project to library and create new library. Now create a new folder and locate it where you wish. And now you can save your proxy media library into a folder that you can locate later. So save that. Only proxy media needs to be selected. Don't tick these two. Copy media is a good idea to select. And also you would modify your settings and change the library to the folder that you've just previously created, and then say OK to that. And it'll now ask you to transcode, because as we saw previously, there was no proxy media created. So by transcoding that, they will stay red until the transcoding process has completed. And you'll notice up here in the status bar that it's currently transcoding those files. As they are created, you will see proxy media will appear here in green. And you can see that one's now turned green, and the red will go away when they're all completed. And you can see that that's showing as got proxy but no original media. And incidentally, just make sure that you either have proxy preferred or proxy only, because if you have optimized media selected, so they're going to show red. Now, if we look at the finder, here's the folder that we saved all the files into, and there's the Final Cut proxy media, and it's showing all of the proxy files. And then this one is the original media. Now, there will be some original media because the audio sound effect isn't able to be made into proxy media. So in this case, Final Cut will always copy the original files if it can't make proxy files out of it. If we select one of these now and bring it into QuickTime, if we come to the window menu, we can open the QuickTime inspector, and we can see that this is ProRes proxy media. What I want to do now is show you how to reduce the size of that proxy media and make it into H.264 proxy. And what we should do here is come to the preferences under Final Cut, and if you go to the import tab, you can see create proxy media there, and we can pre-select this, and by default, it will make ProRes Proxy. So we're going to now force it to make H.264 Proxy. We'll go back to the original event here and select the project, come to Copy Project to Library, New Library. This time we'll have a new folder and we'll call that H.264. Change the settings again, but this time to the new folder, H.264 Proxy. It's going to ask us to transcode again because now it's making proxy media for H.264 and not for ProRes. We've got proxy preferred selected and there is the proxy media appearing. If we select some of these ones here, we can see that's got proxy media in it and the progress is happening in the status bar here. So now when we come to the Finder, we can see the H.264 proxy folder. If we select one of these proxy media files now and bring that into QuickTime, let's go to the inspector now and we can see here that we've now got H.264 proxy. Now let's compare the size of these files. The ProRes proxy you can see is 1.8 gigabytes and the H.264 proxy, 50%, is 157 megabytes. So the H.264 proxy is obviously the one that we prefer to send over the internet, and so we can put that on Dropbox or on any transfer method. And when that's opened on the remote computer, if we double click the project, you can see that now is in the timeline. Since there is spare footage there, we can actually extend some of these clips. We can extend the end clip a little. Once we've completed that edit, all we need to do now is actually transfer the actual library itself back over the internet, and you can see that that's 4.7 megabytes. It's even likely that you could email that. It's a good idea to rename that. Let's call it modified version 2. And once that's received by the originating computer, it would be wise again to just change the name of the project to modified, just so it's different. And just to check, if we go to the view menu now and we select optimize, then all of those files are offline because there's only proxy media in here. All we need to do now is, here's the proxy media library. Here's the project that's in that library. We simply drag that project now and put it in the original event and ask for the original media. It will say that the original media doesn't exist, but let's just continue. And now when we look in that library and we double click the modified version, and you can see that this one here was extended as far as it goes. And if we check and look at optimized media only, you can see that the optimized media has linked back to that proxy media project. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell.